Hello and welcome to Python Fundamentals. In this course, we learn the underpinning Python programming skills, preparing for our journey towards mastering the Django framework and the Python programming language. This tutorial is part of a series of tutorials. You can find the link to the whole playlist in the video description. This tutorial is from our Python Programming Fundamentals for Django Developers course, which you can find and purchase on Udemy. You will find all the latest and updated tutorials, as well as resources and assessments to help accelerate your learning of the subject. The link to the course, which will always provide the best price, can be found in the video description. In the previous tutorial, we created a new table, a database table. Now, typically, we want to then explore this table. So we can now go ahead and create a new Django admin user so that we can access the Django admin site and then potentially interact with our table and data. So let's go through the process of creating a new Django admin user. This is where we left off in the previous tutorial. We created and migrated a new Django model and created a new table in our database. So now we want to access it. Now we can access tables within the terminal. Of course we could, but it's a lot easier to view our data using the Django admin site. So first of all, if you're on Windows, you're going to type in py. If you're on Mac, you can type in ./ and then manage.py. And then let's go ahead and create a super user. So we have done this before in this series, in this course, just to formalize this. So username, now you can type in any username you like. Email address isn't required, so I just press enter, and then the password will not show when you type, but it will be utilized. So I type in admin, enter, and then admin and enter again. It tells me it's short, but it's okay just for this purpose. Obviously, I highly recommend you use much more effective username and passwords for your builds if you are going to make your website live. So I press Y to confirm, and there we go. Right, so now we've created a new user. We could inspect it in actual fact. If I go into my SQLite, open that up, you will need the SQLite or SQLite extension for this. I can go in, I can go into the users here, I can show the table, and you can see this is the user that I've just built, or we've just built. It has a password, you see it's encrypted. You can see the username is admin and some other flags that indicate the fact that this user is an admin staff user, as well as the join date. So now we can activate Python 3 or however you want to do this, manage.py, and we can then now run the server and access the admin site. So just take a note of where your server is running from if you haven't already done so. Let's go back in and access our web page and then slash, and then we need the admin at the end. Apologies if you didn't see that. I'll do that again. So up at top here, although it's very small, apologies. So 8,000 and then just admin slash. So that's the URL that you need to save or make a note of. Right, so that takes us to the admin page here. I use the username and password that I've just generated and created, and there we go. By default, you can see that our table that we created in the previous tutorial doesn't appear on this list. So let's move into the next tutorial where we learn how to register a new Django model to the admin site.